I have explained with the help of two video series 34 and 35 the working capital assessment methods known as MBBF method and sales turnover method. Today, why this video series 36, let us discuss the cash budget method, which is also one of the methods used by banks in assessing the working capital finance requirement of a manufacturing concern. In the MBBF method, while calculating the eligible working capital finance, the basis was the investment in the current assets. Similarly, in the case of a sales turnover method also, the starting point was the investment in current assets. Only difference between MBBF and the sales turnover method is, in the sales turnover method, we assumed that the investment in the current assets will be 25% of the projected sales. Now, compared to those two methods which we have already dealt with, in the cash budget method, the peak cash deficit is the basis for arriving at the working capital limit. This method was recommended by a committee headed by Kannan committee. The business enterprise will be required to furnish the projected cash budget, say for a period of 1 year, which is broken into month-wise cash flows or quarter-wise cash flows. Let us first understand the industries where this cash budget is more useful. There are some industries where current assets are not visible, still they need working capital finance. Examples are a software industry or a construction activity. Similarly, the cash budget method is also used in cases where the activity is seasonal in nature. For example, firecrackers manufacturing unit, agro-based unit like sugar industry, coffee and tea processing units, etc. So in such cases, the cash budget method is found to be more useful. Now, in this method, only the pure cash inflows and pure cash outflows will be taken into account. In a business, the cash inflow and cash outflow take place on account of operational and non-operational activities. When I say operational activity, means I am selling the product against cash, cash is coming in, I am paying my salary by way of cash, cash goes out, etc. The non-operational activities are divided into financing activity and investment activity. When I say financing activity, some of the examples for cash inflows are, the business is increasing the capital, or the business is borrowing funds from the banks, or the business is floating debentures, cash comes in. Similarly, the business is paying interest, the business is paying the installment, cash outflow takes place. These are examples for cash inflows and outflows on account of financing activity. Similarly, whenever the investment takes place, such as the investment in fixed assets or the investment in the share market, cash outflow takes place. Similarly, when I am selling some fixed assets, or I am getting a dividend from the investment made, or I am selling some of the shares, cash inflow happens. These all come under the category of cash inflows and outflows on account of financing activity. But when we do the working capital assessment based on cash budget method, only the cash inflows and outflows on account of operational activity alone will be taken into account. Now, for the operational activity, the cash inflows, as I have told you, occur when the business is making a cash sales, cash is coming in. The business is receiving some advance from the buyers, cash comes in. The business collects the trade debt on the due date, cash comes in. Similarly, the cash expenses like cash purchases, payment of wages, payment of salary, payment of administrative expenses, payment of selling expenses, which are on account of payment of cash, cash outflow takes place. Now, let us understand how the cash budget method works. The borrower gives you a monthly statement of cash inflows and cash outflows from the operational activity. So for every month, we add up the cash inflows, add up the cash outflows. If the cash inflow is more than the cash outflow, there is a surplus. On the other hand, if the cash outflows are more than the cash inflows, there is a deficit. Wherever there is a surplus, the business does not require financial assistance. But on the other hand, whenever there is a deficit, the deficit needs to be funded. So suppose we take the cash flows, inflows and outflows for a period of say 12 months. For every month, the bank works out the surplus or deficit. Then they take the cumulative deficit or surplus. So you will see that when you take the cumulative, in certain months it will be surplus, in certain months it will be deficit. And the deficit or the surplus, the amount keeps on varying from month to month. For the bank, the peak cash deficit occurring in a specific period will be the sanction limit. The drawing limit will be the deficit occurring in each month. Say for example, in the month of January, there is a surplus, which means in that month, the drawing limit will be zero. Suppose for the month of February, the deficit is 10 lakhs. So for that month, the drawing limit will be 10 lakhs. Suppose if you take a specific period of 12 months, during the 12 months, the peak cash deficit is 25, the 25 lakhs will be the sanction limit. This is how the cash budget method works in a bank. I hope you have understood the mechanism of cash budget method, and if you have understood it and liked it, press the like button and subscribe to this channel. We will go into another related topic in the next video. Thank you very much.